ഭക്തജനാത്യഹന്തുകുപതിത്തമന്യേഷു അവിചാര്യദൂർണം സ്തംഭേവദാരസ്തമനന്യലഭ്യം ലക്ഷ്മീ നൃസിംഹം ശരണം പ്രപത്യേ അഹോബിലേ ഗരുഡശൈലമധ്യേ കൃപാവശാത് കൽപ്പിതസന്നിധാനം ലക്ഷ്മ്യാ സമാലിംഗിര വാമബാഹം ലക്ഷ്മീ നൃസിംഹം ശരണം പ്രപത്യേ ശ്രീമദേ ശ്രീലക്ഷ്മീ നൃസിംഹ പരബ്രഹ്മണേ നമ അസ്മദ്ഗുരുഭ്യോ നമ അസ്മത്സവരഗുരുഭ്യോ നമ അസ്മത്പരമഗുരുഭ്യോ നമ ശ്രീമതേ ശ്രീ ആദിവന് ഷഡഗോവേന്ദ്ര മഹാദേശികായ നമ ശ്രീമതേ ശിവന് ഷഡഗോപ ശ്രീ വേദാന്ത ദേശീയേന്ദ്ര മഹാദേശികായ നമ ശ്രീമതേ ശ്രീ ലക്ഷ്മീ നൃസിംഹ ദിവ്യ പാദുകാ സേവക ശിവന് ഷഡഗോപ ശ്രീ നാരായണ ഇരീന്ദ്ര മഹാദേശികായ നമ ശ്രീമതേ ശിവന് ഷഡഗോപ ശ്രീ രംഗനാഥ ഇരീന്ദ്ര മഹാദേശികായ നമ നമോ നമോ യമുനായ യമുനായ നമോ നമഃ നമോ നമോ യമുനായ യമുനായ നമോ നമഃ യോ നിത്യമച്യുത പദാംബുജ യുഗ്മരുക്മ വ്യാമോഹദസ്തധിതരാണി തൃണായ മേനേ അസ്മദ്ഗുരോർഭഗവതോസ്സ ദൈകസിന്ധോ രാമാനുജസ്യ ചരണൌ ശരണം പ്രപത്യേ ശ്രീമാൻ വെങ്കടനാഥാര്യ കവിതാർക്കിക കേസരി വേദാന്താചാര്യവര്യോ മേ സന്നിധത്താം സദാ ഹൃദി വന്ദേ വൃന്ദാവനചരം വല്ലവീജനവല്ലഭം ജയന്തി സംഭവം ധാമ വൈജയന്തി വിഭൂഷണം രാമാനുജദയാപാത്രം ജ്ഞാനവൈരാഗ്യഭൂഷണം ശ്രീമത് വെങ്കടനാഥാര്യം വന്ദേ വേദാന്തദേശികം ശീരൊൻറുതൂപ്പുൽ തിരുവേങ്കടമുടയാൻ പാറൊണ്ട് சொன்ன பழமொழிகள் ஓரொன்று தானே அமையாதோ தரணியல் வாழ்வார்க்கு வானேறப் போமளவும் வாழ்வு இதை மொழிந்தருளும் வேதாந்த தேசிகனார் பாதாரவிந்த மலர் பத்தியுடன் என் பற்று சுதர்ம ஞான வைராக்கியம் സാത്യ ഭക്തി ഏക കോചര നാരായണ പരം ബ്രഹ്മ ഗീതാ ശാസ്ത്രേ സമീരിത പ്രസംഗാത് സ്വസ്വഭാവോക്തി കർമ്മണോ അകർമ്മ ദാസ്യ ച ഭേദജ്ഞാനസ്യ മഹാത്മ്യം ചതുർത്ഥ അധ്യായ ഉച്ചതേ പിറവാമൈ തന്നിടത്താനേ പിറക്കും പെരുമകളും തുറവാക്കി ദിശകൾ തൂമതി തന്നാൽ തുലങ്ങുകയും ഇറവാ ഉയർ നന്നിലൈ കണ്ടിടും ഉലകിൻ നിലയും മറവാഴും മായവൻ നെയ്യനക്കണ്ട് അറിവിത്തനേ വി ആർ എൻജോയിങ് ടീക്ക സ്മാൾ ലെക്ചേഴ്സ് കറൻ്റ്ലി വി ആർ ലുക്കിംഗ് ത്രൂ ദി ഭഗവത്ഗീത ചാപ്റ്റർ 4 കാൾഡ് കർമ്മയോഗ. At the beginning, Krishna was telling, I told these things to Surya, and then Surya told to Ishwagu and all their vamsam and everything. And Arjuna was puzzled and he was asking, Krishna, I thought you were telling me. How could you have, you are born along with me as a colleague, how you could have told to Surya? Then Krishna was telling about, let me tell you about all of them, and he was telling about this avatara ragasyam. In the Avatara Ragasyam, we have seen six slogas and everything, five slogas, and then followed by another one. Bhagavan's avataram shows saulabhyam, very easy accessibility. That is the reason why Bhagavan, Yasha Narayana Shriman Shira Anna Vinikethanaha Nagabaryangamuttrischa Yagado Maduramburi, as Arivamsam sloga says, he has come down all the way from Adisation, lying down in Tiruparkadal Chirabdi, coming down as a vibhavavataram. It shows the saulabhyam. He has come only just for us. And easy accessibility, easiness of the attainment. The avatara ragasyam reveals why he has come, how he has come, and how do we benefit out of his compassionate nature descending down to the earth. And the last sloga we say, Ye yadamam prabhatyande താം സ്തദൈവ ഭജാമ്യഹം മമ വർത്മ അനുവർത്തന്തേ മനുഷ്യാ പാർത്ഥ സർവശഃ. ഈസ്റ്റലിംഗ് ഏ പാർത്ഥ സൻ ഓഫ് പൃഥ, Whatever the way people are surrendering to me, I reciprocate. I do it in a reply back to them accordingly in the same way, in the same manner what they have desired. Everyone understands my swabhavam, follows what I have told and my path, and gets stabilized in their condition of the bhakti. That is what the essence we saw. The way you approach me, you do the surrender to me, I will do anugraham in the same way. This is very much the same for the bhakti yoga. There are 31 brahma vidyas are there. In out of the whether you do the Thakara Vidya or Sad Vidya or Shandilya Vidya or Madhu Vidya or whatever the Vidya you are doing, in the Anusandhanam, in the Anushtanam, how you do that one, that is the way Bhagavan is giving you the protection for you and Bhagavan is blessing for you. So Krishna was telling the way you do, that is the way you can attain me also. About the glories of his avadaram, ragasyam, he told in an incidental fashion. Prasangigam. Edo solla vanda, I was trying to tell. So suddenly I remembered I am telling you. So that is what he is doing. Not as a main subject in the fourth chapter. It was inserted because there was an occasion Krishna found. We commonly see somebody, how come why you are come here? What is the reason? Is there anything you need? If you ask somebody, he says, no, I was just passing along this way. Nothing important, I just come this way. So people say like that one. Similarly, Krishna prasangigam, just he thought of that one, and that is how he was telling about the avadara ragasyam. If Krishna was so easy, accessibility, saulabhyam, and any which way you can pray to me, that is what he says, why people are not going to Krishna and do the sharanagari and attain moksham? That is puzzling. If Krishna is so easy, why people are not doing that one? For this, Bhagavan is answering here. Now he is going to detail about the karma yogam. Karma yogam in the fashion of jnanakaram. What it means, karma yoga is not doing a job, not doing a ritual, not doing a task. Just doing the job, you cannot do that one. Actually, karma yogam, why are we doing that one? Where the palan is going to do that one? What is our part in that one? All those things you have to realize, that is the jnanam. So, it is in a way of a knowledge and intelligence, karma yoga. That is what he is going to tell. To emphasize and also to illuminate people, one who does the karma yoga has to have the intelligence of why and what and everything. That is, in ours we call as the Satvigatyagam. Na mama, we say that one when you are trying to do in the Prabhati. So the same thing in any of the Karma Yoga, nothing belongs to you. So you have to understand why are we doing and where does it go. That attitude you needs, that one. So as a preface for this one, Krishna is going to tell four slogans who are all eligible to do the Karma Yoga, and two slogans, the greatness about the Karma Yoga and the following thing. So we'll try to enjoy some of these things when we do the Avadara Ragasyam. Along with this one, these are also very important one we have to remember. That's why again we'll try to do a few slogans in this aspect. The next sloga is 4-12. It says, Kaṅkṣanda karmaṇām siddhim yajanta iha devadhāham Chibram hi manushe loge siddhir bhavadi karmaja. Kaṅkṣanda karmaṇām siddhim yajanta iha devadāham Chibram hi manushe loge siddhir bhavadi karmaja. Very straightforward, simple sloga. Kaṅkṣantaha karmanam siddhim. Kaṅkṣantaḥ avdina, to be desired, to be indulged for something somebody is craving for. So that is called kaṅkṣanta. Kṣanta means basically indulging. Kaṅkṣanta, very seriously he was looking for. Karmanam siddhim. Karmanam siddhim, actually you cannot say karma yogam completion or karma purti. No, we are not talking that. We are talking about karma palan. Karmanam siddhim abdina. By doing the karma, what are you going to have that one? Fulfilling the karma, what are you going to get? Karma palan. Kankshantaha karmanam siddhim. What does it mean? By doing some karma, he is going to get some benefit. In that benefit, he is so much interested in. So, based on the karma palan, he is doing some kind of a karma. Yajanta iha devadaha. Yajanta, praying, worshipping, doing some aradhanam, puja. Iha devada, here means in this place, that is on this earth. Devadaha means all the children devada, not the Adipurushan, Sriman Narayana, but all others like Vayu, Varuna, Indra, Shiva, Brahma, all those things. Yajanta iha devadaha. So, kankshantaha karmanam siddhim. Yajantaiha devadaha means, in this world, lot of people go and pray to the demigods, the other devadas, idara devadas. Why? Because they do certain kind of a ritual and they are interested in what palan. By doing this, you're going to get this palan. By doing this, you go. What is that one? That is the Purvagandam. Purva Mimamsa says, karmas under palan. And that is what most of the people are interested in, Krishna was saying in the first line. Then, karmaja manushe loge. Karmaja. As the fruit of the karma, manushe loge, human beings in this world. These are the things people do as a fruit of the karma. Manushe loge means wherever the manushas are there. Manushas means not necessarily bhulogam. It includes all the human beings, all the jivatmas. It includes all the devalogam and brahmalogam, all of them put together. So you can say manushe loge means basically prakriti mandalam. So as a fruit of the karma, in this prakriti mandalam, kshibram hi siddhir bhavadi. Kshibram. Chibra means very quickly. Remember Vibhishana also, when he was doing surrender to Lord Rama, he said, Chibram, go quickly and tell Lord Rama that I have come here to and doing this surrender to him. Chibram means very quickly. He, that means as a filler, that is a, in general, indeed, also something like that. Siddhir Bhavadi. The reason why people are doing in this world and they get the palan in this world itself very quickly. And that is what it, the second line says. The first line it says they go and pray to the demigods, either a devada and everything, because they are interested in a karma palan. That is why they are doing. Second line says, Chibramhi manushe loge. Very quickly in this world itself, Siddhir Bhavadi, they get the palan, karmaja, whatever the karma, the ja, the palan for that one, what is coming out of the karma, the palan, they get it in this world itself. So that is what basically the Anyabhadesam it says. In this world, people have the attitude, people have the desire, wish for the karma palans. That is why they go and do the worship of the idara devadas. In the Manushya Logam itself, you don't have to cross the Viraja river or anything. Here itself, you get the appropriate rewards for that karma very quickly. That is what it says. Let us understand clearly what Krishna is trying to tell in the Swabhadesam. However education one might have, however jnanam we may have, it doesn't matter all the way at the bottom of the society or all the way at the top. Whether he is educated least or the most, whether he has got least wealth or most wealth, people are always interested in worldly benefits, worldly rewards. So, ulaga vishayam, when we say that one, humans cannot avoid this one. We are all born with this one. The atma maybe wants to go The Dharminyanam may say, I am a slave to Bhagavan, I want to go and do Kaikariyam. But it is connected with the Panja Jnanendriyam, Panja Karmendriyam and Manasu, and all of them goes Atmanam, Radhinam, Vidhin, Ramar, everything goes into that direction. What is the connection between us and the wife, or the husband, or the kids, or the house, or the car, or the computer, or the money? Nothing. Atma is not connected to any of them. The Atma is not even connected to our body. It's only in this Janma we are using this one as a vehicle. Other than that, there is no connection. But what we do? We want a good wife. We want a good husband. We want good kid. We want a nice job. We want a big house. We want no disease at all. We want good food, etc., etc. For that, we always go to the either a Devada, smaller gods like Surya and Brahma and Shiva and everything. This is no exception. Most of them are like that. Even Mumukshus you take. We may be Prabhanna only today. Someday in our life, not necessarily all of them, many of us. Okay? So, Janmasiddhi Sri Vaishnava, only very few people. But most of us, what we had done in our past, we went to either a Devada, go to that temple, pray to them, they want to get this one, go here, and this is the dosha nivaranam, go and do this one. We have done all these things. Why? Because we are interested in very quick palan directly from them, first one. Second, we didn't understand the correct details of everything. So, Paradevara Paramarthika Adhikaram in Vagasetra Saram Swami Desigan says, who is the Paradevadai and why we should go to him and everything. We have seen all of them. So, many want to attain palan very quickly, but not careful to look what is the dosham, what is the defects in this one. Krishna says here, Arjuna, no one understands, or at least many of them, they don't understand. No one means those people who go to the either Devada, they don't understand. I am the Atma in everything. Sharira Atma Bhavam. Sharira Shariri Bhavam, that is going to come in the chapter 13th. So, all the Aradhanam, all the worship, all the prayer, all the havis you give in your Yagam and everything, Yagyam, and homam finally comes to me only. Samanadigaranyam. Anything you tell relate to the body, it always relate to the Atma inside. So, Bhagavan is the final one. And I am the one feeling very happy on your karma, whatever the ritual you do, and I am the one blesses. These are all intermediary. Through them I bless you. Many don't understand this one. They could have directly come to me, but they don't do that. They go to the either Devada and thinking they are the one giving all these things. Instead of that, they go to Indra and Chandra and all those things, assume the rewards they can give, and they can give very quickly and everything. All they can give, alpa astira palan, that can be obtained from them, easily from the demigods. If that's so, we ask the question, if the demigods are giving those things very quickly, demigods means intermediary, okay? They are not the final one. So we are not talking about a supermarket where it says and everything. From there, there's a local shop buys all of them and he tries to sell it to you as a retailer. So these are all the retail gods. They are not the final one. So Adi Bijam, Adi Moolam, when we say that one. So, now we are asking the question, if the Idara Devadas are going to give the palan very quickly, and they have the power of that, will Krishna, can you give this one to me or not? Krishna, can you give this one to me very quickly or not? We will always have a doubt. So, that we are asking, Krishna will not give useless palans. We have to understand that. Why? A true mother will do only good to the kid, to the children. Children may keep on crying and asking and doing all the kinds of things, all the They want the potato chips. Mother knows you are sick. I cannot give you the potato chips. If I give that one, you will fall even more sicker. I cannot give that one, mother. Sometimes mother does all the things which the kid is asking, she is not giving. But it is for who? It is for the goodness, good health of the kid. She does not have the myopic view, but she looks for the long-term benefits and everything. Okay? So, Bhagavadas may go to Krishna, Bhagavada may go to Narayana, Bhagavada may go to Rama and ask, Alpa Astira Palan. Bhagavan knows all these things what you are asking. You don't understand. That's why Krishna tells in Uddhava Gita, Nashwaram Grihya Manancha Viddhi Maya Manomayam. In the Sadhana Sudhishtiyam, when we did the Sibhashyam, the first one is Nitya Anitya Vastu Vivekam. You have to understand which is Nityam, which is Anityam. If you don't understand, then Igamutra Palaboga Viraga, Samadhamadi, Sadhana Sambattakal, Mumukshutvam, all these four are coming. All these are iterative process. You cannot say you have to graduate from all of them. You have to qualify, then only come. We go and hit the wall and we come back. We go and hit the wall again because the world is so easy to attract us into the all the wrong things. So, Nashwaram Grahyamanancha Viddhi Maya Manomayam. We did not understand. So, Bhagavan, what does he want, Krishna? He does not want you to ask for a good wife. He does not want you to ask for a good house. He does not want... Why? Because all of them are temporary. They are real, but they are all perishable. Bhagavan wants us to do Sharanagadi. Krishna is going to tell at the 18-66, he is building all these things here. So he is going to say, Sarva Dharman Parityaja, give up everything. None of them will give you moksha. Only I stand in front of you as a Sanadana Dharmam. Do it to me, he is going to say. Bhagavan wants us to do Sharanagadi. Come and enjoy mokshanandam. I have everything there. It's a blank check. You can enjoy all of them. Instead of that, you are asking, can you give me $1? Can you give me $2? That is what you are asking. Bhagavan does not give you pravritti palan. Pravritti means keeps on going. In the samsaram, you're going to keep on going. He wants you to do and understand and do the sharanagadi and the nivritti palan he wants to do. That is why Desigan, in one of the Tamil Prabandham, he says, Indro Nalayo Endri Nagesegendrane. We wanted to, Bhagavan wants, and as soon as you say that you want to get the moksham, and you are going through the Acharya, Satacharya, and you are doing the Prabhati, at that time, Bhagavan rushes, he wants to give the moksham, but he says, Edaddega Vasane Maam Tutpadam Prabhayaswayam. When you say like that one, ayo, I wanted to give it to him immediately. He says, okay, either it's going to be today or tomorrow. And then he is smiling at that one. I actually wanted to give. This is almost like in Ragasatra Saram, as I usually say, the father has got a huge company. I don't know, maybe any of them like a Buffet or Bill Gates, anybody, something like that one. But his son, he's got all the wealth, all the things. He does not care about father thing. He wants to drive the taxi cab. One day, the son comes to the father. Dad, I made a decision. Father is looking. I think your company is good. I should always look into that one and take a position. Father is so happy, he wants to give you everything. Then he says, maybe after another 5 years. Then how the father would feel. So that is how this is happening here. Bhagavan wants to give the moksha. At least we are asking. There are people who does not even look for that one. They are asking for the alpasthira palan. So other devadas are not like that. When you are asking for a potato chips, when you go to the store, let's assume you are a sick person. When you go to the store, you pay the money. He gives the potato chips. He is not saying that, oh, you are sick, I cannot sell you this. Oh, this is early morning, you should not eat the potato chips. He doesn't say that. Why? Because there is no connection between him and you. Because you two are both jivatmas. He wants to sell, you want to get that one. So they are just giving anything. They are eagerly awaiting. They don't have, they did the tapas, they got the power from Lord Sriman Narayana and they want to use that one. So when you do the aradhana, they give you to that one. Similarly, when you pay the money, they give you the potato chips. They don't care about the hidden for you. They are interested only in the transaction for you. What is the blood relation between the store guy and you? Nothing. What is the blood relation between you and the demigods? Nothing. What is the relation between you and the Bhagavan? Sariraga Shastram. It says, Kudal Tuvakku. He is the mother for all of us. And the Tirunabile is brought the Brahma from which we got. Bhagavan is the Adi. We are connected to him as the mother, as the father, as the guru and everything. Sagala Vidhamana Varavu, like Andal says, all kind of relationship, only Bhagavan is there. So, Bhagavan is the only one who is a Karanam. Karanam Tyudheyaha. Everything else is a Karyam. He is Adi. Everything else is a manifested product. Indra, Vayu, Varunan, Brahma, Shiva, all of them are possessions. They do tapas, they got that position. You graduate from here and you write the exam, you get the IAS position or you get some kind of a position, what you get. Similar to that. But there's a stopwatch there. As soon as your position starts, tick, 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 it starts. When it ends, you have to come down. All this position, Brahma, Brahma, Shiva, Indra, Vayu, Varunan, all of them ends. The position that never ends is Lord Sriman Narayana, because he is the Karanam. You cannot go anything beyond that one. So they are all Jivatma like us. So all the Idara Devadas, they are all like Jivatmas. Bhagavan is the only one gives the power to them. They pray to the Bhagavan, they got that one. One of the slogans in Ragasatra Sarame is seen, Brahma did the tapas, so many kalpam, and they got the Brahma position again. He already had once. He wanted to get again. So that is the desire for the people, you know. So with that power only, when they got it from Bhagavan, they are awarding the other people. So Bhagavan is the Adi. Why do you have to go through the intermediary one? Why don't you go directly to him? And he tells you what is good. Your mother will always do good for you, not the other people. The Hidam, Krishna will do everything for you. Other people are not. So here, Chibram, the word is used. Chibram means quickly, no kala vilambam. Okay? So it shows kala sati, adavade, time connection. We also like that one. Bhakti Yogam and Prabhati Yogam, when you take that one, Prabhati we choose. Why? Because T-I-C-E. Time, intelligence, caste, energy. Time, there. I don't want any kala vilamba. Bhagavan, give me moksha at the end of this one. Don't put me into samsaram again. That is what we are asking. Here, the alpasthira palan, they don't want to wait for all these things. Go to the moksham. Who has got it? Don't rock the boat. Who knows about the moksham, crossing the Viraja river and everything. Let me enjoy everything. All these things are available here. Let me pray this demigod. Let me pray this idara devada and get it. That is what they are. And other people are also telling, I went to this temple, I got my son's marriage fixed. I went to this temple, my office, I got promotion. So people are tempted because of all of them. That is why they don't understand the dosham, the defects in all of them. So kala sati means basically the time connection. Chibra means they get it rewarded quickly. Manushe loge, when it says that one, in the Pragati Mandalam itself, desa sati. Desa Sati means in this desam itself they are getting. I don't have to go to Vaikuntham. I don't have to wait for that one. You get it quickly. So when you are saying Kala, Desa, Sambandham is very near. The connection of the location, the connection to the time, the near future, near location, I get that one. So that is what people are very much interested in. Not somewhere in Vaikuntham, not someday we will get all of them. Not that one. There is a proverb, a small thing that says, Varam atya kakaha shvo mayurat. What it says, what you are interested in getting today is only crow. Tomorrow, you may get a peacock. Oh, no, 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 I don't want a bird in the hand, two in the bush. That is what the same thing here. People are interested in what they get it today, rather than thinking in a longer term, is it good for us? So that is what Krishna was telling. The reason why people are going to the Idara Devada and everything, they want to get it done. And actually what they are getting is not good for them. They don't understand the defects of that one. Arjuna was listening to this one. And he was posing an intelligent question now. Krishna, most people in this world are ignorant. And they are all committed so many sins. Avivegam and Pabi. So they are all like that one. They like only Alpasthira Palans. They will not desire moksham. Because that's the way they are brought in. That's the way. See, most of the people in the world, jnanam is not there. They are not against moksham. They are not against Sriman Narayana. They don't understand correctly. If you tell them the Sharanagari Shastram, I again always tell that one, the product is so good, you don't need any marketing. I don't have to tell, this is great. You will understand that one. So, the Prabhatti Shastra, what Krishna was telling, later on continues on the Uddhava Gita, how you have to behave, is an amazing product. So, people would rush and want to do that one. Why they are not doing? Because they did not have the correct knowledge. Correct knowledge is start from Nitya, Anitya, Vastu, Vivegam. So, all the people here, they want only Astirapalan, Alpapalan. So, they won't desire moksham. If they are not interested in moksham, the karma yoga, what you are telling here, along with the jnana yoga, transfers into the bhakti yoga, they move into the bhakti yoga part, they lead you into that one. With that one, they are going to go to the moksham. So, this is an intrinsic part of a angam, for to go to the moksham in the bhakti yogam. In the bhakti yogam, jnana, karma, both of them are angam. So you have to do as a supplementary product. So you have to do that one. So when it is supposed to be as a part for the moksham, and everybody is interested in alpa asthira palan, who is going to do the karma yogam? Tell me. Will it not become ananushtana lakshana apramanyam? Anushtana, ananushtana, anushtana illada, lakshana, apramanyam, pramanyam, apramanyam. So, is it not going to be a great guidelines and rules for something no one is going to follow? We see many rules like that one. They put all the rules, nobody is following. Then we are asking the question, why did they put the rules? When everybody is not following that, what is the use of that? That is what Arjuna is asking. So, these people are now going to be rushing into what is known as the Alpa Asthira Palan. They are not going to work on the Karma Yogam, Jnana Yogam and Bhakti Yogam and go for the Moksham. That's what you are trying to teach. If that is the case, what is the use of this one? And Krishna is going to answer in the next two slokas. ಕವಿದಾರ್ಕಿಕ ಸಿಂಹಾಯ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣ ಗುಣಶಾಲಿನೇ ಶ್ರೀಮದೇ ವೆಂಕಟೇಶಾಯ ವೇದಾಂತ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ ಶ್ರೀಮದೇ ನಿಗಮಾಂತ ಮಹಾದೇಶಿಗಾಯ ನಮಃ ಅಡಿಯನಡಿಯನ್.